Dear students, welcome to the next lecture of electrical measurement. Now in this lecture we will discuss the measurement of three phase power, or you can say the measurement of power in three phase circuits. So we already know that for the measurement of power we have to use the wattmeters. So if there is a network which is supplied through n number of conductor, let us suppose this is n, small n. So if a network is being supplied by this n number of conductors, then we can measure the total power just by adding the readings of n wattmeters, which are so arranged that the current element of the wattmeter is in each line and the corresponding voltage element is connected between that line and a common point. So we know that in a wattmeter there is a current coil circuit and there is a pressure coil circuit, okay. So the current coil element of the wattmeter should be in each line and the corresponding voltage element of that particular wattmeter should be connected between the line and the common point. Now if the common point is located on one of the lines itself, then we can measure the power by using n minus 1 wattmeters, okay. So this is a special case. Now let us just consider a three phase system. Let us just connect the wattmeter, okay. Let us just first of all draw the three wattmeters. And let us show the load. This is the load. So just connect the current coil here, okay. This will be connected here. And we connect the pressure coils of all the three wattmeters at a common point. Okay, so let this common point be C. Now this is the current coil, this is the current coil of all the three wattmeters, and the remaining coil will obviously be the pressure coil, okay. So this becomes our first wattmeter. Let us show it with a different color. So this becomes our first wattmeter, okay. We can call it as W1. Similarly, this is also a wattmeter and this is the third wattmeter, okay. Now the different currents can be shown as I1, this will be I2, this will be I3, this is the load, okay, this is point O, this is the values of the voltage, that is V1, V2, V3. Okay. And this is the difference of voltage between this point C and point O. We have represented it by this small letter V. Okay. So let us suppose that these different wattmeters, they represent the readings which is denoted by P1, P2 and P3 respectively. Okay. So what we have seen here is that the potential coils of the wattmeter are connected to this common point C, and the potential of this point C will be different from this neutral point O of the load. Okay, so just we have denoted this voltage difference as V. So the instantaneous power in the load will be the instantaneous power in the load can be denoted by V1, which is nothing but V1 I1 plus V2 I2 plus V3 I3. Okay. Now the reading of the first wattmeter W1, that is reading of wattmeter, so the reading of first wattmeter can be denoted by P1, so it will be simply P1 equals to V1 dash I1. Similarly, for the second wattmeter, that is P2, it will be V2 dash I2, and for third wattmeter it will be V3 dash I3. Okay, so now this actually V1 is nothing but V plus V1 dash. So this V1 dash is nothing but the difference of V1 minus V. Okay, similarly, V2 will be equal to V plus V2 dash, and V3 will be equal to V plus V3 dash. Therefore, we can calculate this P1, that is, we can just substitute in place of this V1 dash V1 minus V. So, if we substitute V1 minus V here, okay, so this will be V1 minus V multiplied by I1. Similarly, P2 can be V2 minus V multiplied by I2 plus and the third wattmeter, that is P3, it can be written as V3 minus V multiplied by I3. Okay, so the sum of these three wattmeters, that is P1, P2 and P3, can then be calculated. So let us just sum. So sum of readings of wattmeters should be equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. Okay, so you just have to sum these three. So that will be V1 minus V multiplied by I1 plus V1 minus V multiplied by I2 plus V3 minus V multiplied by I3. Okay, so this will be V1 I1 plus V2 I2 plus V3 I3 minus V times I1 plus I2 plus I3. So we can just look in the circuit by applying the Kirchhoff's current law, that this I1 plus I2 plus I3 will nothing but be equal to 0. Okay, so this factor can just be substituted as 0. So this means that the sum of wattmeter readings will be equal to V1 I1 plus V2 I2 plus V3 I3, and that will be equal to the instantaneous power consumed in the load. Okay, so this actually represents the total instantaneous power, which is measured by 3 wattmeters. Okay, so we can say that the sum of the readings is equal to the power in the load. So whatever be the readings of these 3 wattmeters, it will just show the total power in the load. Okay, so this is how we measure the power in 3-phase circuits by using wattmeter. So generally we have the different methods for the measurement of power. Okay, measurement of that is 3-phase power. So we have the 3 wattmeter method. Okay, similarly we have a 2 wattmeter method as well, in which we use only 2 wattmeters, and we have a 1 wattmeter method as well. Okay, so by using all these 3 methods we can measure the 3-phase power. So this we are talking about the 3-phase power. Okay, so the 3-phase or the 3 wattmeter method we have already discussed for a 3-phase 3-wire system. We can discuss it one more time for a 3-phase 4-wire system. Let us draw the circuit again of 3 different wattmeters. Okay, let us draw the load as well. So just connect it to the different points. So this will be connected here. So this is a 3-phase 4-wire system where we have 4 lines instead of 3. Okay, and again these are the different wattmeters. This is wattmeter 1, which can represent the reading P1. Similarly, this is the second wattmeter and this is the third wattmeter. The different currents can be shown as I1, I3 and I2. This is the voltage V1, V2 and V3, okay, and this is 0.2. So in this particular case, what is the difference from the previous circuit which we have drawn? In this case, you can see that the common point C of the pressure coils and the neutral O of the load coincide. Okay, so then in this case, this means that this V will be equal to 0. So because we have assumed a difference of voltage between the common point and the neutral point in the previous circuit, that difference was denoted by V. So in this case, since the point is coinciding, so that means there will be no voltage difference in this case. So we can just extend the analysis of the previous case here by just assuming V to be 0. So when V will be 0, then this means that V1 will be equal to V1 dash, V2 will be equal to V2 dash, and V3 will be equal to V3 dash. So sum of the instantaneous readings of wattmeter, sum of instantaneous readings of the wattmeter will be equal to simply P1 plus P2 plus P3, that will be equal to V1 I1 plus V2 I2 plus V3 I3. So instantaneous power of the load will be equal to V1 I1 plus V2 I2 plus V3 I3. So this means that these three wattmeters which we are using in the circuit, they are able to measure the power of the load. So simply we have to sum the readings of the three wattmeters and they will give us the measurement of this three phase power which is being consumed by the load. So in this way we can measure the three phase power which is being consumed by the load. Now this was the three wattmeter method. Next we have the two wattmeter method as well, in which we will use only two wattmeters. Okay, there is the requirement of only two wattmeters instead of three. And then we also have a one wattmeter method as well, in which there is only one wattmeter used in the circuit. So that we will see in the coming lecture. So this is all in this lecture. Thank you very much.